My name is Kirsten Garcia.
My name is Ella Thomas.
I'm Abby Rodriguez.
I'm Riley Smart.
And this is a lawsuit about me, Jess. I'll be giving a brief summary over the opening statement that you can see on the screen. The main things that we'll be talking about is the Trail of Tears and Andrew Jackson's position in it, as far as actions are concerned, not just merely based on what he says. The U.S. game land, as for Andrew Jackson and everything else that was involved, as far as neighbors, they lost their homes. Here, as you can see, are the primary documents, the evidence that we are using and are presenting to you in this case. The Cherokee petition, and the removal act, and treaty of Fort Jackson, as well as battle of abortion and war.
Our primary eyewitness accounts that we'll be using against Andrew Jackson in this case. The first one is the Journal of Reference, Daniel S. Westbrook. The Cherokee removal. The papers of Chief John Ross, Cherokee Chief during the Trail of Tears. Agent, Assistant Agent William Calhoun, General of Choctaw removal in that. And General Scott's newspaper article on the Vermont Telegraph with eyewitness accounts. I'll be giving a summary over the argument against Jackson. He had a lot of negative impacts, which included the Battle of Horseshoe Bend, the Seminole Wars, and the Treaty of New. So the Battle of Horseshoe Bend included the Creek Indians, and the Little Creek Indians, most of them agreed to help Jackson gain the Alabama territory from the Red State Creek Indians. He killed many of the Red State Creek Indians, and they won the battle in which the Red Sticks agreed to sign the Treaty of Fort Jackson, which left the Lower Creek Indians feeling betrayed since the treaty gave away half of their land despite their assistance in Jackson's battle. The Seminole Wars were many wars there. But most of the deaths occurred during the Second Seminole War, where the Seminole population was killed in battle, consumed by starvation and disease, or relocated to Indian territory in modern Oklahoma. The next event is the Treaty of New Rochelle. This treaty gave Jackson the chance to steal the gold in the Georgia Territory before the Indians got the chance to use their advantage. That's all.
Okay, now there's going to be some artistic works regarding Trail of Tears. The first image is portrayed to show what the Indians looked like when they were making their trip to Oklahoma. Many of them died along the way. The second one is a painting of a man with the Cherokee alphabet. The third one is another one to show what it was like on their trail to on their trip to Oklahoma. And next we have the interactive map. If you click on, there's five locations, and then each of them talk about the Seminole Wars and what happened to the tribes that were there, and how they all were forced to go to Oklahoma during the Trail of Tears.
I will now be summarizing the closing statement of our argument. As previously stated above, Jackson was a cruel and hateful person that had no regard for the emotions and feelings of the Indians. He, as president, he served for 2 terms, which is 8 years. He did several things to the Indians, which included forcing them to, manipulating them into signing a treaty to leave their home. Their land and proven that Andrew Jackson is not helpful to the Native Americans by sharing statements of people that survived the Trail of Tears, as well as artworks, legal documents, writings of witnesses, and an interactive map that shows how far the Native Americans are forced to travel away from their homes. In light of this, Jackson being president for two terms had several opportunities to commit the actions accused in court today, considering he had a substantial amount of power within the government as the president. The actions accused included the betrayal of the United States through the Allies, though the ally of the Willow Creek Indians, and a tragic death of more than 4,000 Native Americans during the Trail of Tears, as well as the manipulation and removal of the Native Americans in Georgia and near the Dan Gold Mississippi. Think about how the Native Americans must have felt during this difficult time. Imagine having your home and family members ripped away from you in a matter of days. How would you